Amen, amen. Before we start,
antes de comenzar,
if everybody could just extend your hands towards
si pueden
me,
extender sus manos hacia el frente,
for the word of God. Father God, thank you, Lord, for tonight, Father, for all the things that you have done, Father, for the worship that we were able to give you, Father. And we're not done worshiping, Lord. But Father, right now it's time for the word of God. Lord, I pray, God, that this word doesn't come from me, Lord, that it comes directly through you, Father God. Let it be not of me. Let me not mess it up at all, God. Let it be word by word what you want to tell your people tonight, Father. Let your people have their ears open, God, and their minds open, Lord, and their spirits ready, God, for the revelation, Father God, that you're going to give them, Lord. I declare that people will stand up tonight. I declare that those who have been falling, those who have been falling for a long time will rise up today, Lord Jesus. And in Jesus' name, the church declares, amen. Amen.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. So like I said, we are in week 7 of spiritual warfare.
En la semana 7 de guerra espiritual.
And I'm not going to lie.
No voy a mentir.
It's been a rough week for me.
Ha sido una semana fuerte para mí.
It's been a rough day for me just today.
Y un día fuerte hoy.
And it took everything just to get up here today.
Y tomó todo para llegar aquí hoy.
And I couldn't have come up here if I didn't worship like we worship today.
No hubiese podido llegar aquí si no hubiera adorado como
hicimos. If God wouldn't have poured down his spirit,
si Dios no hubiera manifestado su espíritu,
if he wouldn't have filled us up like he did today,
y no hubiera llenado como hizo hoy,
but with that, we can't just let it go. We can't just let the cup go again.
No podemos dejar que el vaso se vacíe.
We need to keep being filled up with the word of God.
Tenemos
Amen?
Que continuar siendo llenos de la palabra de Dios.
And today, as you guys know, when times are hard,
cuando los tiempos son difíciles,
it's hard to worship.
Es difícil adorar.
It's hard to pray.
Es difícil orar.
But God has made us warriors.
Pero Dios nos hizo guerreros.
Inside of us, there needs to be a fighter.
Adentro tiene que haber un peleador.
We can't be naive
no
to the enemy.
No podemos ser, no nos podemos dar cuenta de las cosas malas que el enemigo hace.
Tonight, we finna fight tonight.
Vamos a pelear hoy.
Are you guys ready for it?
¿Están listos?
Are we ready to fight tonight?
¿Están listos a pelear?
All right. So, pull up your Bibles. We're going to go to Ephesians.
Si pueden sacar su Biblia, vamos a Efesios.
Chapter 6.
Capítulo 6.
And we're going to start at verse 10.
Y vamos a empezar en el verso 10.
Verse 10.
Verso 10.
When you have it, raise up your Bible, say amen. We're ready.
Cuando lo tengan, digan amén.
Ephesians chapter 6,
Efesios capítulo 6,
verse 10 through 17.
Verso 10 al 17.
When you have it, if you can all just say amen, let me know that you're here tonight.
Déjame saber que están aquí hoy.
All right, all right. We read the word in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Leemos en el nombre del Padre, Hijo y Espíritu Santo.
A final word. Be strong in the Lord and in his mighty power. Put on all of God's armor so that you will be able to stand firm against all these strategies of the devil. For we're not fighting against flesh and blood enemies, but against evil rulers and authorities of the unseen world, against mighty powers in this dark world, and against evil spirits in the heavenly places. Church, we're not fighting against each other. We're fighting against the sin and evil spirits
no
in others.
No peleamos contra uno al otro, sino contra el pecado y las cosas malignas.
We're not fighting each other.
No peleamos contra uno al otro.
We are fighting the evil spirits that are manipulating those people.
Peleamos contra esos espíritus que están manipulando a esas personas.
All right, verse 13.
Verso 13.
So, therefore,
entonces,
put on all every piece of God's armor, so that you will be able to resist the enemy the time of evil. Then after the battle, you will be standing firm. Amen, amen. Church,
Iglesia,
we need to be standing firm.
Estaremos parados seguros.
Are we standing firm today?
Estamos parados seguros hoy.
Because as Christians, it is very easy for us to get knocked down.
Porque como cristianos es fácil ser derrotado.
You know, we don't expect this when we came to Christ.
No esperábamos esto cuando vinimos a Cristo.
When we came to Christ, we thought everything was going to be fine.
Cuando vinimos a Cristo pensamos que todo iba a estar bien.
We were going to prosper.
Íbamos a prosperar.
From glory to glory.
Y de gloria en gloria.
But there's also a spiritual warfare.
Pero hay una guerra espiritual.
That I hope they told you when you accepted Christ.
Que yo espero que te hayan comentado cuando aceptaste a Jesús.
That's why a lot of Christians gave up.
Por eso muchos se rindieron.
Because they were not able to fight.
Porque no podían pelear.
Or they didn't tell them that they had to fight.
O no le dijeron que tenían que pelear.
And the way that we fight here.
Y de la manera que peleamos aquí.
We fight in the spiritual.
Peleamos en lo espiritual.
Like I said, we don't fight against each other.
No peleamos contra uno al otro.
We're not like physically fighting something.
No estamos físicamente peleando
it
algo.
It is all in the spirit.
Es todo en el espíritu.
But the same thing.
Pero
we have to fight with attitude.
Lo mismo tenemos que pelear con actitud.
Who here has ever gotten in a fight, like a straight up fight?
¿Quién ha peleado aquí?
Okay, we're that kind of church. All right.
Somos ese tipo de iglesia.
But I've never fought before in my life.
Yo nunca he peleado en mi vida.
I've never had that I've never been put in that situation.
Nunca me he estado en esa situación.
But when people get in a fight,
pero cuando alguien está en una pelea,
it's because there was some disrespect going on.
Es porque había algo de no había respeto.
They didn't respect the name.
No se respetaban uno al otro.
So that's how the fight starts.
Y así empezó la pelea.
So what about when the enemy disrespects us?
¿Y qué pasa cuando el enemigo nos falta el respeto?
Why do we just sit down and stand there and do nothing?
¿Qué pasa si nos paramos ahí y no hacemos nada?
Why do we just keep getting hit by the enemy?
¿Por qué nos quedamos ahí siendo dados por
el enemigo? Oh, but if somebody steps in your shoes, then it's a fight.
Pero si alguien se para en tu zapato, ahora peleas.
But if the enemy is ruining your life, you stand there and do nothing?
Pero si el enemigo arruina tu vida,
come on,
no
church,
nada.
We need to rise up and we need to fight with an attitude.
Iglesia, tenemos que pelear con una actitud.
And when we are down,
y cuando estamos bajos,
we cannot stay down.
No podemos quedarnos abajo.
Look, I get it that we're not perfect.
Yo sé que no somos perfectos.
And we will fall.
Y nos caeremos.
We will get knocked down.
Nos caeremos.
But we cannot stay down.
Pero no podemos quedarnos abajo.
That's the whole reason why Jesus went up on the cross.
Por eso Jesús fue a la cruz.
So that we're able to stand up.
Para que nos podamos parar.
So if you stay down,
si nos quedamos abajo,
you're just looking down at what Jesus did.
Vas a mirar a lo que Jesús
hizo. Today
is
the day to rise up.
Hoy es el día para levantarte.
And I'm telling you because it's just something that we felt today.
Y te lo digo porque eso es algo que sentimos.
Everybody
hoy
was silent.
Todo el mundo estaba callado.
But we were worshiping.
Estábamos adorando.
Come on, church, we need to rise up today.
Vamos, iglesia, hay que adorar.
I don't know if you need to be shaken, if you got to shake your brother, shake
si
your neighbor.
Que estremecer a tu.
But we need to rise up tonight.
Tenemos que levantarnos hoy.
When we come back,
cuando volvemos,
when we go back from being down,
cuando regresamos de estar bajos,
we need to come back stronger.
Tenemos que regresar de fuertes.
We gotta come back stronger.
Tenemos que regresar más fuertes.
Because if we go up the same way that we went down,
porque si nos caemos, si nos levantamos de la misma forma que nos caímos,
then you're just gonna be hit over and you'll fall again.
Pues te van a dar de nuevo y vas a caer de nuevo.
In every loss, there's a lesson.
En cada pérdida hay una lección.
But us, we get so stubborn sometimes.
Pero a veces no sabemos.
Sometimes we're such sore losers.
Somos cabeciduros y perdemos mal.
That we just take the loss.
Y nos quedamos con la pérdida.
We take another loss.
Y cogemos otra pérdida.
And we don't learn the lesson.
Y no aprendemos la lección.
So if you're wondering why do I keep falling down again and over and over?
Si estás tratando de descifrar por qué sigues cayéndote.
It's because you're not grabbing the lesson.
Es porque no estás cogiendo la lección.
Jesus, God let you fall.
Dios deja que tú te caigas.
So that you can learn a lesson from it.
Para que aprendas algo de eso.
So that you can learn to rely on Him.
Para que pongas tu confianza en Él.
So if you fall down the same way,
si te caes de la misma manera,
it's because you didn't grab the lesson.
Es porque no cogiste la lección.
And when we come back stronger,
y cuando venimos más fuerte,
we need to fight for what's ours.
Tenemos que pelear por lo nuestro.
We need to fight because the enemy is trying to take away what belongs to you.
El enemigo está tratando de quitarte lo que te pertenece.
And for some of you, he has already done that.
Y para muchos él ha hecho
it's
eso.
It's time to take it back.
Es tiempo de tomarlo.
It's time to take back your purpose.
Propósito.
It's time to take back those gifts that are for you for to glorify God.
De tomar lo que es tuyo para glorificar a Dios.
It's time to take back what belongs to you.
Es tiempo de tomar lo que te pertenece.
That's why we need to come back stronger.
Por eso tenemos que regresar más fuertes.
And tonight I want to just go over, this is some fighting tips.
Y estos son unos tips de pelear.
How to get back in the fight.
De cómo volver a la pelea.
Amen. Are y'all ready?
¿Están listos?
Are we ready to learn how to fight tonight?
Van a aprender cómo pelear hoy.
All right. Let's go real quick back to Ephesians chapter 6.
Vamos a Efesios capítulo 6 de nuevo.
Let's finish it off in verse 16.
Verso 16.
When you have it, say amen.
Cuando lo tengan, digan amén.
Amen. All right. Verse 16.
16.
In addition to all of this, take up the shield of faith with which you can extinguish all the flaming arrows of the evil one. Take the helmet of salvation and the sword of the Spirit, which is the Word of God. Amen?
Amen.
So we need to have the armor of God on
Tenemos
in order to fight.
El armamento de Dios.
Many of us try to go back to fighting the enemy.
Muchos tratamos de pelear el enemigo.
Without putting on the armor again.
Sin el armamento.
And we already had a Bible class about the armor of God.
Y tuvimos una lección, un estudio bíblico sobre el armamento.
So I just want to go over three of those armor pieces.
Y quiero ir sobre tres de esos pedazos.
Just so that you, and as I'm telling you this.
Y te digo esto.
I want you to ask yourself.
Y quiero que te preguntes.
Do I have the armor on?
Tengo yo el armamento.
Do I have that armor that I'm supposed to have in order to fight the enemy?
Tengo yo el armamento que se supone que tenga para pelear.
Amen. Y'all ready for it?
¿Están listos?
All right. So let's start with the sword.
Empezamos con la espada.
The sword is obviously it's the word of God.
La espada obviamente es la palabra de Dios.
By the way, here at Wildfire Church, we take notes.
Y aquí en Iglesia Wildfire tomamos notas.
So if you want to pull up your notes app or if you have paper and pen.
Si quieren tienen un papel o un bolígrafo, tomen notas.
Let's write it down.
Vamos a escribirlo.
So that when times are hard,
para que cuando pasemos dificultades,
you can go back to the word of God.
Podemos regresar a la palabra de Dios.
And be filled.
Y ser llenos.
And know what to do.
Y saber qué hacer.
All right. So to explain the word of God, to explain the sword.
Para explicar la espada.
Let's go to Hebrews chapter 4.
Vamos a Hebreos capítulo 4.
Hebrews chapter 4 verse 12.
Hebreos capítulo 4 verso 12.
When you have it say amen.
Cuando lo tengan digan amén.
Hebrews chapter 4 verse 12.
Hebreos capítulo 4 versículo 12.
Hebrews chapter 4 verse 12.
Hebreos capítulo 4 verso 12.
Amen.
Amen.
All right. Let's get it. So verse 12.
Verso 12.
For the word of God is alive and powerful. Can we repeat that, church? Alive.
Repetimos eso. Vivos.
And powerful.
Y poderoso.
It is sharper than the sharpest two-edged sword, cutting between the soul in the spirit, between joint and marrow. It exposes our innermost thoughts and desires. Amen. So I'm sure that you've heard this before.
Creo que han escuchado esto.
It's in Christian culture, it's like all we do.
Cristiano, esto es todo lo que hacemos.
We hold up the Bible like it's the sword.
Tenemos una Biblia como una espada.
But it's not like a sword that you play around with.
Pero no es una espada con la que tú juegas.
It's not a sword that you just put you show off on Sundays and then you put it down on Monday.
No es algo que usas el domingo.
Come on, the sword is something that we fight with daily.
Es algo que peleamos con ella diario.
We need to read the word of God.
Tenemos que leer la palabra de Dios.
So that we can fight back against the lies of this world.
Para pelear contra las mentiras del mundo.
Because if we don't read the Bible,
si no leemos la Biblia,
we're going to start believing the stuff that people say.
Vamos a empezar a creer lo que la gente dice.
What the news say.
Lo que dicen las noticias.
My dependence is not on what the news is saying.
No dependo de lo que dicen las noticias.
My dependence is on God and what he said.
Dependo en lo que dice
that
Dios.
I already have the victory.
Y yo tengo la victoria.
I am protected.
Que soy protegido.
We need to read the word of God.
Tenemos que leer la palabra de Dios.
So when in the verse, if you noticed,
en el verso si te notaste,
it said that it is sharper than the sharpest two-edged sword.
Dice que es más cortante que las espadas de dos filos.
That means that it's a sword that has two edges.
Significa que es una espada que tiene dos filos.
So even as you use it,
y cuando la usas,
it does hurt the flesh.
Sí, duele la carne.
It hurts the flesh.
Duele la carne.
Because it is the truth.
Porque es la verdad.
And sometimes we want to do things.
Y a veces queremos hacer cosas.
And we read it in the word of God.
Y lo leemos en la palabra de Dios.
And God is saying not to do it.
Y Dios dice no lo hagas.
It cuts you.
Nos corta.
But it's a good cut.
Pero una cortada buena.
It makes our flesh weak.
Nos hace la carne débil.
It hurts the flesh.
Le duele a la carne.
And that's good.
Y eso es bueno.
We need less of us.
Necesitamos menos de nosotros.
And more of him.
Y más de él.
So I know that I know that reading the word of God may be hard.
Yo sé que leer la palabra es un poco difícil.
You know, more and more we are not used to reading now.
Y hoy en día no estamos acostumbrados a eso.
But we need to endure.
Pero tenemos que durar.
And read the word of God daily.
Tenemos que tratar de leer la palabra diario.
Amen.
Amén.
Not that many amens for the word
Hay
of God.
Hay muchos amén para
but
la palabra right. de Dios, pero okay.
It is a double-edged sword.
Es una espada de doble
filo. So remember that in your mind.
Recuérdate de
eso. If you ever read the Bible and you're like, man, why is it so hard?
Si a veces lees la Biblia y dices, ¿por qué es tan
like
difícil?
Asleep,
me estoy durmiendo.
I'm tired.
Estoy cansado.
It's because it's a double-edged sword.
Es porque una espada de doble filo.
But you know that it's going to be good for you.
Pero tú sabes que va a ser bueno para ti.
It's going to be good for your soul.
Va a ser bueno para tu alma.
Amen. Amen. All right. Let's go into the shield.
Vamos al escudo.
The shield of faith.
El escudo de fe.
Let's go back to that to verse 17. Real quick, it said, "Take up the shield of faith, with which you can extinguish all the flaming arrows of the evil one." You have to take up the shield of faith.
Tienes que coger el escudo de
so
la fe.
So it's not something that's attached to do.
No es algo que está contigo.
It's something that you need to pick up.
Es algo que tienes que agarrar.
And I did a little research about shields back
then. Y yo rebusqué sobre escudos.
Because I've always, you know, we talk about the shield.
Y hablamos mucho del escudo.
And then we say, oh, you gotta have faith. That's all you gotta do.
Y decimos, tienes que tener fe. Eso
Just
es todo.
Pick up your faith.
Coge tu fe.
But I'm like, all right, there has to be something else along with that.
Pero yo dije, tiene que haber algo más sobre eso.
So I looked up, and Paul was obviously a citizen of Romans.
Y Pablo estaba hablándole a los romanos.
And a Roman shield,
y un escudo romano.
It was around 10 pounds to 20 pounds.
Era entre 10 a 20 libras.
And you know that may not sound like a lot.
Y a lo mejor eso no suena como mucho.
But after a while,
pero después de un tiempo,
it does weigh.
Sí pesa.
Brother Fox, if you can come up here real quick.
El hermano Fox va a pasar.
So I brought here just as an example.
Y como un ejemplo traje esto.
It's 10 pounds.
Estos son 10 libras.
I'm sure everybody can bench 10 pounds, right?
Y mucha gente aquí todos podemos levantar 10 pesos.
Not that much.
No es tanto.
All right, so just hold up the 10 pounds.
Él la va a aguantar.
But you gotta hold it like a shield, though.
Pero tiene que aguantarla como un escudo.
And that's the hard part.
Y esa es la parte difícil.
That's the hard part.
Eso es lo difícil.
You have to be standing.
Tienes que estar parado.
And standing firm.
Firme.
With the shield.
Con
up,
el escudo arriba.
So that it can go against all the flaming arrows that are going.
Coger todos los dardos del enemigo.
And the push back against the enemy. But you gotta keep the shield up.
Tienes que levantar el
so
escudo.
It's not as easy as just saying, oh,
no,
I have faith.
No es tan fácil decir, tengo fe.
No, it takes endurance to hold up the faith. Oh, no, come on, bro. That's the
tienes que durar. That's
where the sword is. You gotta come
ahí
with the shield.
Tienes el escudo
so you have
en esa
to
mano.
Endure.
Tienes que tener resistencia.
And there's times, I know this is your collarbone. But see, when you need help,
cuando necesitas ayuda,
who do you call on?
¿A quién llamas?
You have to call on for the Lord.
Tienes que llamar al
so
Señor
that he can help you
para que él te ayude
with the shield
con ese escudo
against all the arrows
contra
and all the enemies.
Que el enemigo está
he will help you go so that you can keep moving forward
él te va a
in life
para que puedas seguir
against
caminando.
Every pushback,
contra
against
todo
every
empuje,
arrow, against
dardo.
Every thought. He will hold you up.
Él te aguanta.
But you gotta ask for him.
Pero tienes que preguntar por ayuda.
And the wonderful thing about being in a community of Christ.
Y lo más mejor que es estar en la comunidad cristiana.
Is that we can hold our shields together.
Es que podemos aguantar
and
nuestros escudos
in a community.
Juntos. Y estar en una comunidad.
So that when I'm weak.
Para que cuando yo sea
débil. My brother can hold me up.
Mi hermano me aguanta.
And that's why we go to church.
Y por eso vamos a la iglesia.
Because it's not easy.
Porque no es fácil.
It's not easy to fight in the spiritual.
No es fácil pelear en lo espiritual.
We need each other to back each other up.
Nos necesitamos para estar ahí uno al otro.
So that when one is falling away,
para que cuando uno se esté yendo,
the person can say, hey,
el otro lo mire.
I'm praying for you.
Le diga, estoy orando por ti.
Not only am I praying for you, but I'm going to make sure that you are in the right path.
No solo estoy orando, pero voy a asegurarme que esté bien.
And it may annoy you.
Y cuando estén sacándote mal,
I may annoy you with texts,
te voy a enviar muchos textos,
but I can't let my brother or sister fall down.
Pero no puedo dejar que te
That's
caigas.
Why we are Wildfire Church.
Por eso somos
and
Wildfire
we don't let
Church.
Each other down, right, church? Come on. Amen. We stand together as
Nos paramos
the unit.
Juntos como una unidad.
Amen. So we need to ask God for strength
Tenemos
when you're
que
weak.
Preguntarle a Dios por fuerzas cuando estemos débiles.
Having faith has weight.
Tener fe tiene peso.
And after a while,
y después de un tiempo,
it can get hard.
Es difícil.
But you need to ask for help.
Pero tienes que preguntar por ayuda.
We don't fight alone.
No peleamos solos.
A lot of us have tried that, probably.
Muchos hemos tratado eso.
To go through all our situations.
Ir por todas situaciones.
To go through all our problems by ourselves.
Y todos nuestros problemas solos.
And we end up even more broken than how we entered.
Y terminamos más rotos de como empezamos.
So I know that maybe some of you grew up where they taught you that you have to fight alone.
Muchos crecieron como aprendiendo que tienen que pelear solos.
That you don't need to rely on anybody else.
Que no debes de depender en otra persona.
But I invite you tonight.
Pero te invito hoy.
Into a new way of life.
A una manera nueva de vida.
Where you do have brothers and sisters that care for you.
Donde tienes hermanos y hermanas que te.
Where you have a God that will provide everything.
Un Dios que provee todo.
This is the new life that we have.
Esta es la nueva vida que tenemos.
You no longer have to walk alone, church.
No tienes que caminar solo, iglesia.
Let's walk together.
Caminemos juntos.
Amen. And then let's go into the helmet of salvation.
Y vamos a el casco de salvación.
The helmet of salvation.
El casco de salvación.
It's about knowing who you are.
Es de saber quién tú eres.
It's about knowing that I am a child of God.
Saber que eres un hijo de Dios.
So it doesn't matter what attacks come.
No importa qué ataque venga.
It doesn't matter what lies come against me.
Qué mentiras vengan en contra de mí.
I know who I am.
Yo sé quién soy.
And that's a problem with this generation.
Y ese es el problema con esta generación.
That we are losing our identity.
Que pierden su identidad.
We are losing ourselves.
Nos perdemos nosotros.
And we're trying to be like everybody else.
Y tratamos de ser como el resto de ellos.
But God just wants you to be you.
Pero Dios quiere que seas tú.
God wants you to know, to keep it in your mind, that you are a child of God.
Que mantengas en tu mente que eres su hijo.
The other thing that the helmet does.
Y la otra cosa que hace el casco de salvación.
It protects your eyes.
Protege tu vista.
It protects your eyes.
Protege tus ojos.
So that you can keep your eyes on God.
Para que puedas mantener tus ojos.
Because
en Dios.
If I know that I'm a child of God,
porque si sé que soy un
I know that
Dios,
I need to keep looking at Him.
Sé que tengo que mantener mi mirada en Él.
If I forget that I'm a child of God,
si se me olvida,
then I'm not going to look for Him.
Pues no lo voy a buscar.
I'm just going to do whatever I want.
Voy a hacer lo que yo quiera.
So we need to keep our eyes on Jesus.
Tenemos que mantener nuestra mirada en Jesús.
In this fight,
en esta pelea,
we can't focus all our attention on the enemy.
No nos podemos enfocar en el enemigo solamente.
We can't focus on the situations that are around us.
En la situación que está alrededor.
It's like that storm that Peter was walking on water through.
Es como en la historia que Pedro estaba caminando en la agua.
As he was just looking at Jesus.
Él solamente estaba mirando a Jesús.
And he was able to walk through
y,
the waters.
Y él pudo caminar sobre el agua.
But as soon as he felt the winds.
Pero cuando sintió el viento.
And he felt the pressure.
Y la presión.
He let his eyes go away from Jesus.
Dejó que sus ojos se fueran
and
de
he
Jesús,
fell.
Y cayó.
That's why a lot of us fall.
Por eso muchos caemos.
Because we're not reminding ourselves daily that we are children of God.
Porque no recordamos que somos hijos de Dios.
So if you haven't heard it,
si no lo has escuchado,
you are a child of God.
Eres un hijo de Dios.
Whatever you did yesterday doesn't matter.
Lo que hiciste ayer no importa.
You're still a child of God.
Eres un hijo de Dios.
It doesn't matter in your worst day,
no importa en tu peor día,
or in your best day,
o en tu mejor día.
God still loves you the same way.
Dios te ama igual.
So we don't need to live in shame anymore.
No tenemos que vivir en avergüenza.
When we do something bad, when we sin,
cuando hacemos algo malo, pecamos,
we tend to be like, oh Lord, I don't deserve you.
Decimos, Dios, no te merezco.
I'm no longer a child.
No soy un hijo ya.
But God is just running after you, saying that yes, you are.
Pero Dios corre detrás de ti, te dice sí eres.
You are still a child of God.
Eres todavía un hijo.
All you
mío.
Need to do is come back.
Solamente regresa.
You need to do the comeback.
Regresa.
Don't stay down.
No te quedes abajo.
Come back.
Regresa.
Amen.
Amen.
So it doesn't matter what Satan throws at us.
No importa lo que Satanás nos tire.
We know what we're fighting for.
Sabemos por qué estamos peleando.
If you know what you're fighting for,
si sabes para qué estás peleando,
it's going to be a lot harder to put you down.
Va a ser muy difícil.
You know, it's like when we go to work,
vamos al trabajo,
we know why we're working.
Sabemos por qué tenemos que trabajar.
Because we have a family at home that needs to be fed.
Porque hay una familia en casa que tenemos
There's
que
bills
suplir.
That need to be paid.
Hay biles que tenemos que pagar.
And no way am I gonna let my family starve.
Y no voy a dejar que mi familia
so it doesn't
pase
matter
hambre.
If I only slept 2 hours.
So si dormí 2 horas,
I'm gonna fight.
Voy a pelear.
I'm gonna go to work.
Voy a ir al trabajo.
Not because I feel like it.
No porque quiero
but
ir.
But because I have to.
Pero porque necesito.
There's a family I gotta feed.
Hay una familia que
necesita. In the same way, we should be a soul. soldiers of Christ.
De esa misma manera debemos ser soldados de Cristo.
We need to say that we are fighting this battle.
Estamos peleando esta batalla.
And I'm gonna fight it no matter how I feel.
Y voy a pelear no importa cómo me sienta.
Amen, church.
Amén, iglesia.
It doesn't matter how I feel.
No importa cómo me sienta.
I'm gonna keep fighting.
Voy a seguir peleando.
Because there's people that need to hear this message.
Porque hay personas que necesitan
Because there's
este
people
mensaje.
That are dead inside.
Hay personas que están muertas
that
adentro.
I need to reach.
Que tengo que ir a alcanzar.
Because there, God has put a message on my life.
Porque Dios me dio un mensaje adentro.
That people around me,
que gente alrededor,
and people that I'm going to meet,
y gente que voy a conocer,
need to hear.
Necesitan escuchar.
Church, let me tell every single one of you.
Déjame decirle, iglesia,
that God has put a message inside of you that other people need.
Que Dios ha puesto un mensaje dentro de ti que
Everything
alguien necesita.
You've gone through,
todo lo que has ido,
is part of your testimony.
O has pasado, es parte de tu testimonio.
And people need to hear that testimony.
Y la gente necesita escuchar ese testimonio.
If you keep wondering why you went through what you went through,
si tú sigues pensando por qué fui pasé por esto,
or the deaths that we have felt,
o las cosas que hemos pasado,
and the people that we have lost,
las personas que hemos perdido,
it's because people need to hear that testimony.
Es porque alguien necesita ese testimonio.
Because there's somebody in this world that's going through the same things that you went through.
Porque hay una persona que está pasando lo mismo que tú.
And they need to hear how God redeemed you.
Y tiene que escuchar cómo Dios te
And
redimió.
They need to hear how God transformed you.
Cómo Dios te transformó.
And how He brought you back to life.
Y cómo te trajo a la vida.
So
de
are
nuevo.
We going to spread that message, or are we just going to stay down?
Vamos a expandir ese mensaje, o nos quedaremos abajo.
We need to fight for it.
Tenemos que pelear.
So those were three of the pieces of armor that we have.
Esos son tres de los pedazos de armaduras que tenemos.
So I want to teach you a fighting move.
Y te quiero enseñar un movimiento de pelea.
Putting it all together.
Para ponerlo todo junto.
It's called the counter. El oponer.
Se llama el oponer.
And it's a move that they use in boxing.
Es un movimiento que usan en el boxeo.
That when the enemy is hitting,
que cuando el enemigo te va a dar,
you step back,
retrocedes,
and you attack back.
Y atacas de nuevo.
So, when the enemy is attacking you,
cuando el enemigo te ataque,
you can't just stand still.
No puedes quedarte parado.
You can't just stay there like.
No te puedes quedar quieto.
Because that's going to knock you out.
Porque te va a dar.
You need to be standing firm.
Necesitas pararte firme.
So when the enemy attacks,
cuando el enemigo te ataca,
you need to either A,
o A,
step back,
te coge un paso atrás,
or you block,
o bloqueas,
because you have the shield of faith, right?
Porque tienes el escudo de la fe, ¿verdad?
So when the flaming arrows come,
cuando vienen los dardos,
you block,
bloqueas.
When those doubts come,
cuando las dudas vengan.
When all those thoughts of depression come,
cuando la depresión y los pensamientos
vengan, when situations are trying to put pressure on you,
las situaciones te pongan presión,
you block,
tú bloqueas,
you block the attack,
bloqueas el ataque,
and when temptation comes,
y cuando venga la tentación,
you step back,
te paras atrás,
because the word of God says that you need to run away from temptation.
Porque la palabra dice que tienes que correr
it's
de la tentación.
It's not something that you can win against.
No es algo que puedes ganar.
It's not something that you can just block.
No es algo que puedes bloquear.
You gotta step back.
Tienes que pararte atrás.
And then counter.
Y después le das algo de vuelta.
Because God says to resist the enemy.
Que Dios dice resiste.
Resist the devil and he will go away.
Resiste al diablo y él huirá.
So we need to stand firm.
Tenemos que pararnos firmes.
We need to stand firm, church.
Tenemos que pararnos firmes, iglesia.
We need to counter.
Tenemos que darle algo
de
vuelta.
It's time to stop letting the enemy hit you.
Es tiempo de parar que el enemigo te dé.
And doing nothing about it.
Y dejarlo que y hacer nada.
That's why God says you need to be alert.
Por eso Dios dice sea alerta.
Stay alert.
Y quédate alerta.
Stay praying.
Quédate orando.
You need to discern what the enemy is trying to do.
Necesitas tener discernimiento para saber lo que hace el enemigo.
Like the verse said, you got to stand firm against the strategies of the devil.
El verso dice que tienes que pararte firme contra las estrategias del enemigo.
So we need to be discerning.
Tienes que tener discernimiento.
What the enemy is doing throughout the week.
Para saber lo que el enemigo hace en la
so
semana.
So if you've been having a bad week,
y teniendo una semana mala,
the devil's up to something.
El enemigo está tratando de hacer algo.
The devil is up to something.
El enemigo está tratando de hacer algo.
If you feel that there's a lot of stuff going your way,
si tú sientes que hay muchas cosas que van
from
hacia
different
ti,
directions,
de diferentes direcciones,
you know that the devil knows,
tú sabes que el enemigo sabe,
that God is about to bring something into your life,
que Dios va a traer algo a tu vida,
that you're about to break through a season that you've been going through,
que vas a romper con una etapa.
So the enemy is trying to stop it.
So el enemigo está tratando de parar.
Are you gonna let the enemy stop you?
¿Dejarás que el enemigo te pare?
Or are you gonna take what belongs to you?
¿O vas a coger lo que te pertenece?
Are you gonna gonna take what God has given you?
¿Vas a agarrar lo que te pertenece?
Are you gonna let people not hear your message?
¿Dejarás que nadie escuche tu mensaje?
Or are you going to counter?
¿O vas a darle algo de vuelta al enemigo?
Or are you gonna fight back?
¿O vas a pelear de nuevo?
We need to counter, church.
Tenemos que dar algo puesto al enemigo.
And one of the ways that we counter.
Una de las maneras que hacemos eso
is through our worship.
Es adorando.
I don't know about y'all,
no sé de ustedes,
but when there's a lot of pressure on me,
pero cuando hay mucha presión sobre
when
mí,
it feels like everybody is against me,
cuando siento que todo el mundo está en contra,
well, financially,
financieramente,
with family,
con la familia,
with my life,
con mi vida,
I run to worship.
Voy a adorar.
Because worship,
porque la adoración,
is stopping what the enemy wants you to feel.
Para lo que el enemigo quiere que tú
sientas. The enemy wants you to feel down.
El enemigo quiere que te sientas
bajo. The enemy
bajo.
Wants you to keep looking down.
Quiere que sigas mirando.
The enemy
bajo.
Wants you to just listen to depressing music.
Quiere que escuche música que te deprime.
So the way we counter that,
y para nosotros contrarrestar
is through
eso,
our worship.
Es en nuestra adoración.
So when, like, when they feel a lot of pressure on me,
cuando sentimos presión,
I like to put that praise music.
Yo pongo esa alabanza.
Because it's very like upbeat.
Porque tiene mucha
it kind of like shakes you up.
Y te estremece.
Some Tasha Cobbs in there.
Pongo
come on, Tasha
Cobbs.
All right. You have to put. You have to stop what the enemy is trying to do
tienes
in your
que
life.
Contrarrestar lo que you el enemigo
can't,
hace.
You can't feel the way the devil wants you to feel.
No puedes sentirte como el enemigo quiere.
We need to fight back.
Tienes que pelear de nuevo.
And I know that we're tired.
Y estamos cansados.
I know that we're tired.
Sé que estamos cansados.
Of the attacks that are constantly coming.
Y los ataques siguen viniendo.
We're tired and our shield, we're just like breaking down.
El escudo está pesado.
But that's the moment in which you need to step up.
Pero ahí tienes que levantarte.
And push forward.
Y seguir empujando.
With my worship.
Con tu adoración.
With my prayer.
Con tu oración.
Sometimes you just need to go to your secret place.
A veces tienes que ir a tu lugar secreto.
Put everything else away.
Poner todo lo demás afuera.
Put your phone away, put everything away.
Tu teléfono lo dejas fuera.
And have that connection with God.
Y tener esa conexión con Dios.
A lot of times the reason we fall,
muchas veces nos caemos,
is because there's been a disconnection from your father.
Porque hay una desconexión del padre.
And it is so easily to get disconnected.
Y es tan fácil ser desconectado.
You know, it's as easy as just having one day of bad things happening.
Es tan fácil como tener un día de muchas cosas malas.
One day of somebody telling you something that hurts.
Un día de alguien decirte algo que te duele.
And then we just disconnect.
Y después nos desconectamos.
We need to connect back to God.
Necesitamos conectarnos
a Dios. We need to stand
Dios.
Up, church.
Parémonos, iglesia.
And the worship team can start coming.
Y el equipo de adoración puede pasar.
Before we end, I just want to read this one more verse.
Y quiero leer un verso más.
2 Corinthians.
Segunda de Corintios.
Chapter 4.
Capítulo 4.
Verse 8 through 12.
Verso 8 al 12.
When you have a church, say amen.
Cuando lo tenga iglesia, diga amén.
2 Corinthians.
Segunda de Corintios.
Chapter 4.
Capítulo 4.
Verse 8 through 12.
Versículo del 8 al 12.
Amen. When you have it, all say amen.
Cuando lo tengan, digan amén.
All right. Are we ready to fight, church?
¿Estás listo para pelear?
Amen. Verse 8. We are pressed on every side by troubles, but we are not crushed. We are perplexed, but not driven to despair. We are hunted down, but never abandoned by God. We get knocked down. But we're not destroyed. Come on, church. Are we not destroyed?
No estás destruido,
can somebody
iglesia.
Just say that we're not destroyed?
Dilo, tú no estás destruido.
I may have been knocked down.
Te empujaron abajo,
but I am not destroyed.
Pero no te han destruido.
Through suffering,
por el sufrimiento,
our bodies continue to share in the death of Jesus.
Nuestro cuerpo continúa de estar junto a la muerte de Jesús.
So that the life of Jesus may also be seen in our life.
So la vida de Jesús también se puede ver en nosotros.
Yes, we live under constant danger of death.
Sí, vivimos en constante peligro de muerte.
Because we serve Jesus.
Porque nosotros servimos a Jesús.
It is so that the life of Jesus Christ will be evident in our dying bodies.
Es para que la vida de Jesús sea evidente en nuestros cuerpos.
So we live in the face of death.
So vivimos en la cara de la muerte.
But this has resulted in eternal life for you.
Pero esto resulta en vida eterna para ti.
This fight
esta pelea.
The victory is not found here on earth.
No está ganada o victoria no está ganada aquí en la tierra.
The victory is when we're all up in heaven.
La victoria es cuando estamos todos en el cielo.
So church, we need to keep fighting until that moment happens.
Iglesia, tienes que seguir peleando hasta que pase.
Because Jesus is coming soon.
Porque Jesús viene pronto.
We are in fourth quarter already.
Estamos en la cuarta etapa ya.
We need to endure and make it to the finish line.
Tenemos que terminar completo.
It is not about how fast you go.
No es cuán rápido tú vayas.
It's just about finishing.
Es para terminar.
It's about when you fall.
Es cuando tú te caigas.
You get back up.
Tú te levantas.
Because you have to finish the race.
Porque tienes que terminar la carrera.
And there's people that you need to bring with you.
Hay personas que tienen que venir contigo.
There's people that you need to have say their testimony to.
Hay personas que tienen que enseñar tu testimonio.
But if we're down,
pero si tú estás en el piso,
then that message will never be delivered.
Ese mensaje no podrá llegar.
God has commissioned all of you.
Dios ha comisionado a cada uno de ustedes
to make disciples,
para ser discípulos,
and to follow Christ in everything.
Y seguir a Cristo en todo.
So are we going to do that, church?
So vas a hacer eso, iglesia.
Or are we going to stay seated down?
O te vas a quedar sentado.
Are you going to fight for your blessing?
Vas a pelear por tu bendición.
Or are you just going to stay down?
O te vas a quedar sentado.
Church, right now it's time to fight.
Iglesia, es tiempo de ya pelear.
And it's time to bring some attitude to
es tiempo de tener una actitud.
Because I'm no longer standing down.
Porque ya no voy a estar.
I don't know about y'all, but I'm not sitting down anymore.
Ya no me voy a quedar sentado.
I'm not going to let the enemy keep hitting me.
No voy a dejar que el enemigo esté atacándome.
I'm going to fight tonight.
Yo voy a pelear esta noche.
So I invite you to church.
Yo te pido, iglesia,
to stand up.
Que te levantes.
And let's worship Christ.
Y adores al Señor.
Do that counter.
Pelea.
Let's fight back.
Que es pelear para atrás.
It's time to fight back.
Es tiempo de pelear
para
atrás.
If you feel like coming to the altar, you're more than welcome
to. Si quieres venir al altar,
puedes. This is your night.
Esta es tu noche.
To come back.
De volver para atrás.
Not just to come back.
No solamente volver atrás.
But to come back stronger.
Pero volver para atrás más fuerte.
Are we ready, church?
¿Estás listo, iglesia?
Are we ready, church?
¿Estás listo, iglesia?
Padre God. Oh, santo Dios.